Now let's cover the situation you already have a web application and want to add a web API. Not very hard, but it takes a little more effort. So let's say we have a web application, an empty one, and I won't add a web API this time. I will click OK. Okay, and now as you can see, there's nothing there. We have no, well, we have references of course, but web API is not in it. And we don't have any folders, no global applications file. What you can do now is use the NuGet package management tool. So right click web application and manage NuGet packages. And then what you can do is choose the browse tab and simply look for web API. And there you have it, Microsoft ASP.NET web API. And click install. Now what will happen here is, as you can see, there's some stuff you need to install, and you just say okay, that's good, it's okay with me, we have licenses to accept, and there you can see references are added. Okay, now we have the references, the library, web API, but we still don't have the folder structure and the files we need. Now the easiest way is just go to your other project or create a project with web API and simply copy all the stuff. We will do this now together. So we have a folder app start, controllers and models. Scripts is from another project. So first, app start. Okay, right click, add a new folder, app start. You want another folder which is called models, and another one which is called controllers. And we will put it here. Okay. Now in the app start, there is the configuration file from web API. So let's have a look. This is how it looks. And what we can do is just copy this. And in our other project, we will add a new class called webapiconfig.cs. There it is. And now we simply add the code here. As you can see, there is a reference missing. What you can do in Visual Studio 2015, just hover over it or right click and then click quick actions, and there you can see the using that is missing. And there is everything you need to do to make it work. Okay, first file, web API config. Next, just have a look. We have the controllers folder, the models folder. Well, that's okay. The global applications file. This we can add in another way. We can just right click the project, click add new item, and then we have to choose from web, and then we have the global application class here. The name is already correct, we add it, and then as you can see, there's a whole lot of functions we don't really need. Just compare again with the other project. As you can see, we only need the method application start. Copy this line here, application start, paste it, remove the rest, and again add a reference. That's still not enough. Add another reference, and there you have it. Web API is added to your and integrated to your web application you already had. In the next lessons, we will use this project to add everything else we want to do. Thank you for watching this video and spending your precious time with this tutorial. I always try to get better at these tutorials, so if you have any comments, please leave them below. If you have learned something new, I would really appreciate it if you give me a thumbs up. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you in the next tutorial.